Thank you, Miss Devi and the school choir. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
Very good morning, too.
Mr. Hendro Wijaya, the superintendent of Bina Bangsa School.
Ms. Martha Hapsari, Academic Supervision Division, Bina Bangsa School.
Ms. Aven, Chinese Academic Supervision Division, Bina Bangsa School.
Madam Pang Yue Shu, Chinese Academic Supervision Division, Bina Bangsa School.
Ms. Jennifer Wu, Chinese Academic Supervision Division, Bina Bangsa School.
Mr. Richard Herawati, Principal, Bina Bangsa Secondary School, Kebon Jeruk. Guests of honor, head of departments, teachers, parents, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to Bina Bangsa School's 18th commencement ceremony 2023.
Good morning. I am Nathaniel Zalbutra.
And I am Eileen Pangesuchandra.
And we will be your masters of ceremony this morning.
We will begin today's ceremony with an opening prayer. We would like to welcome Mr. Donnie to lead us in prayer.
Good morning. Let us put ourselves in the presence of the Lord. Let us bow down our heads and pray. Father in heaven, we pray for guidance and direction for these graduates. Help them to have a tender heart to recognize your Spirit's leading and to clearly hear when and how you choose to speak. Please make their path straight and clear and help them to not lean on their own understanding, but in every way acknowledge you, knowing you have their best in mind. Father, we pray that they will not lose heart when things look dim, but that they will hold firm and faith that your timing is perfect and that you are a detailed planner. Today, we want to honor you for the amazing things that you have done. When we were thirsty, you provided a refreshing water. When we were hungry, you prepared a banquet. When we were under a storm, you become our strong fortress. When we needed someone, you came to our rescue. Truly, your love is perfect, and your compassion is never ending. Lord, we also remember all the parents who are here. Life is filled with challenges, but they remain faithful to their calling by nurturing their children to the best of their ability. We pray that you bless them from head to toe. We want to also lift up to you the school leaders, teachers, and our school. May we always remember the God-given mission to train young minds to become the pillar of the future. May you continue to anoint Bina Bangsa School now and forever. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, Mr. Donnie.
Now, it is our pleasure to invite Mr. Richard to give the opening address. A very warm welcome to Mr. Richard.
Distinguished guests, faculty members, proud parents, and the brilliant graduates of Bina Bangsa School. It is with great honor and excitement that I stand before you today to commemorate this momentous occasion. Slightly a bit different generation, yeah? One with iPad, one still with paper. As we gather here to celebrate our graduation, let us reflect upon the transformative power of technology, the Zoom, the yielding commitment of lifelong learning, and the irreplaceable spirit of grit that have shaped our journey, your journey. In this era of rapid technology advancement, we find ourselves living in a world that is constantly evolving. The digital landscape has revolutionized the way we live, we work, and connect with one another. Some of us connect more with mobile phone and WhatsApp than directly, right? From smartphones in our pockets or the iPads in our bags to the vast expanse of information at our fingertips, the technology has empowered us to navigate a complex digital landscape and has served as catalyst for change. It has sparked our curiosity, enabled us to dream bigger, and equipped us with the tools to turn those dreams into reality. But of course, with these transformative innovations come the need for continuous adaptation and learning. So let us not forget that technology is only as powerful as the minds that wield it. It is our commitment to lifelong learning that fuels our ability to adapt, to grow and thrive in this digital age. The world we enter after this graduation, university, maybe work later on, is dynamic and ever shifting. It presents us with new challenges and opportunities all the time. Embracing a mindset of continuous learning is essential for remaining relevant and seizing the boundless possibilities that lie ahead. Lifelong learning is a mindset that encourages us to embark on a journey of self-discovery, to broaden our knowledge and skill sets, and to constantly seek new horizons. It is an acknowledgement that our education does not end with a certificate, but it is an ongoing process that extends throughout our lives. With technology as the catalyst, we have witnessed the democratization of knowledge, enabling us to engage in self-paced learning, access educational resources, UAIS, and connect with friends, teachers, or even experts around the globe, the world. You have professors coming to speak to you sometimes ago, right? The path of lifelong learning is not always smooth. It requires a steadfast resolve and unwavering determination to persist in the face of obstacles and setbacks. It is here that the true power of grit emerges. Grit is the tenacity, perseverance, and resilience that enable us to overcome challenges, push past our limits, and achieve our goals. It is the unwavering belief in our abilities that and the willingness to embrace failure as a stepping stone towards success. Throughout our educational journey, we have encountered countless moments that tested our grit. That late night spent poring over textbooks and iPads, the daunting exams that demanded your utmost dedication, and the setbacks that threatened to derail your progress. But with each challenge, we found that the strength to persevere, to push ourselves beyond what we thought possible, and to emerge stronger on the other side. It is this very grit that will continue to propel us as we step into the next phase of our lives. Let me pause here for a moment and ask you this. What do you think of the speech prepared by the ChatGPT? So good, right? ChatGPT is an excellent example proving that the world will keep changing. The changes and the challenges in the future is not just competing with fellow graduates, looking for jobs maybe in the future, but also maybe the jobs that you're looking for exist no more in the future. If a principal speech can be easily made by OpenAI, then in the future, perhaps speechwriter is no longer needed. There will be challenges ahead of us, and those challenges possibly by AI, not just by friends or colleagues. It won't get easier for sure, but then when the road becomes tough, let us remember that we have God Almighty, Jesus Christ the Lord, and the Holy Spirit in us. In Isaiah 41:10, God has promised us this. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous hand. Trust in the Lord, Proverbs say, with all your heart and lean not on your understanding. In all your ways, submit to him, and he will make your path straight. As we stand here on the precipice of the new chapter, let us not only celebrate our achievement, but also recognize the responsibilities that lies ahead. Let us embrace the transformative power of technology as a force for good. You have learned this. Technology is not a method, it's a tool. Depends on you. We want to use it for good, leveraging it to solve pressing global issues, bridging societal gaps, and create a more inclusive and sustainable future. Let us commit to a lifelong journey of learning, fueled by curiosity and thirst for knowledge. Let us commit ourselves to never-ending growth, for true education does not end with a diploma or certificate. Let us embrace challenges that lie ahead, for they will be the catalyst for our personal and professional growth. Let us nurture our thirst for knowledge, for it is the driving force behind our ability to adapt and excel in the ever-evolving world. Let us hold on to our grit, unwavering determinations to confront challenges head-on, to persevere in the face of adversity, and to leave our mark on the world. And above all, of course, let us lean on our God all the time, for he is good. Class of 2023, as we celebrate this remarkable achievement today, let us express our gratitude to our teachers, mentors, parents, and the loved ones who have supported us on this journey. Let us celebrate our collective accomplishment, knowing that we have the power to shape the future with our unwavering dedication to lifelong learning and unyielding spirit of grit. Congratulations, graduate. May you embark on this new chapter with the confidence, resilience, and curiosity that will enable you to conquer and any challenge and achieve greatness. The world awaits for your contribution. And I have no doubt that you will make an indelible mark on the tapestry of our shared humanity. God bless you all.
Thank you, Mr. Richard, for that speech.
Now, our guest speaker today is our very own alumnus, Rinaldi Nathanael, who after making his mark as a BBS prefect counselor, graduated with a Bachelor of Arts in Liberal Studies from Waseda University in Tokyo, Japan.
His exceptional talent and commitment led him to be recognized as student champion at the renowned Vital Sassoon Academy in Shanghai, China. In 2018, Rinaldi's career reached new heights when he was named star hairdresser at the esteemed Cosmo Butte, Indonesia.
Mr. Rinaldi's influence extends far beyond the salon as well, as he has built a substantial presence online. With an impressive 1.1 million followers on TikTok and 120,000 followers on Instagram, he has captivated audiences worldwide with his talent. So without further ado, it is our pleasure to invite Mr. Rinaldi Nathanael to give his speech.
A warm welcome to Mr. Rinaldi.
Oh, good morning, everyone.
大家早上好. Should I speak in English or Chinese?
English, yeah.
Okay. Quite nervous. It's been so long since I come to this school. Probably about 12 years since I am here. So good morning, graduates. Wow, what an incredible moment we have here today. To the amazing graduating class of 2023, congratulations for reaching this milestone. I'm Rinaldi, and most of you probably know me as Ray from TikTok. And I'm standing here today as a proud alumni of this awesome school, just like you'll be in a few years. As I look at each one of you, I can't help but feel a surge of nostalgia. I can still remember the good old days when I walked this assembly hall, 6:30. I don't know what time you guys come. This time 6:30? Okay. Trying to make it here on time, read books, attend chapel, hoping that I wouldn't be caught late to the morning assembly. Trust me, high school was a wild ride and filled with ups and downs, but it's a journey that we all share. Most of you will continue your studies to the university, I assume, and please let me say this to you guys, especially to the parents. University isn't just about the academics. I take it as a time for personal growth, for discovering who you truly are, and for forging lifelong relationships. You will meet people from all walks of life, literally all walks of life, from different backgrounds, ethnicities, interests, and experiences. Embrace this incredible opportunity to broaden your horizons and to step outside your comfort zone. And of course, to build a network of connections that will support you and inspire you throughout your life. Also, let's not forget about the adventures that await you guys beyond just the classroom. University is a time when you discover everything outside the classroom, actually. Take advantage of every opportunity to travel, to study abroad, to try new things, and to immerse yourself in different cultures. As you guys see, I was a graduate from Japan, from Tokyo Waseda University. And you can imagine the amount of different backgrounds that I have to live in. And it was amazing. Actually, if you think about it again, that's the thing that I remember the most about university. Yeah, not the lessons. Because to me, life is never, I repeat, life is never about the destination. The destination is the same, guys. It's about the journey. It is through these experiences that you will grow into the amazing individuals you are destined to become. School and university just happen to be a part of that journey. And now I don't want to bore you with a long speech, so let me share a few nuggets of wisdom that I've picked up along the way. Consider these life advices that may come in handy as you embark on your journey. One. Embrace change and failure. Yes, you heard me right. Embrace failure as your greatest teacher. Take it as an entrance fee to success. Nothing is free. It's an entrance fee to success. You gotta pay. Sometimes the price of failure's lesson, sometimes you will have to pay more than one ticket, more than one failure. And that's okay. You guys are young, and the price of failure is still cheap. You can fail again and again. Don't be afraid to take risks and make mistakes and learn from them. That's the important part. It is through failure that we discover our true strength and resilience. And your comfort zone will easily become your greatest enemy as you grow up. Number two, find your passion. Explore different interests, pursue different passions, and find what truly makes you happy. Anything. When you do what you love, success will just come naturally. I mean, I have a lot of teachers here that I know that may still remember me. I was quite academic in school. I did great in science and math. But my passion is in hairstyling, and this is where I found my success. And that's okay. And I know a person who I work with who loves to talk and talk and talk for days. And she found success by being a great communicator as a PR in a global company. That's a passion. You like to talk. You can work as a talker, you know? Number three, surround yourself with good people. You are the company that you keep. So choose wisely who you surround yourself with. Surround yourself with people, with friends who lift you up, who inspire you, who gives you positivity and believe in your dreams. Together, you will conquer mountains. Number four, as Mr. Richard has said, stay curious. Very important, stay curious. In a world where answers are available everywhere, there is ChatGPT, there is OpenAI, there's everything, you know. It has now become more valuable for every one of you, especially in this era, to have the skill to ask good questions, not have good answers, to ask good questions, and to always ask questions. And now let me leave you with a few quotes that have inspired me along the way. A quote on success. Success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. If you love what you are doing, you will be successful. On fear of starting out with imperfection, for those of you who are perfectionists, who finds it hard to start something new, if you are not embarrassed by your first beginnings, I repeat, if you are not embarrassed by how you begin, you have started too late. Everyone who has been successful in this life must have a very embarrassing beginning, and that's okay. And last, on humility and to stay humble. Do not climb the mountain so that the world can see you. Climb the mountain so that you can see the beauty of the world. Okay? Class of 2023, you are an extraordinary group of individuals. As you step out into the world, embrace your uniqueness and chase your dreams relentlessly. Don't forget to enjoy the journey as well along the way, okay? Remember that life is not about the destination again, it's about the journey and the adventures along the road. Congratulations, you've got this, and I can't wait to see the incredible journey that you're going to go through in this world. Thank you.
Let us put our hands together for Mr. Rinaldi. Mr. Rinaldi, could you please remain on stage?
We would now like to invite Ms. Jennifer Wu to present the guest speaker with a token of appreciation. Thank you, Ms. Jennifer and Mr. Rinaldi. Before we move on to our next agenda, though, may we request that the owner of a silver expander plated B2377BZR briefly head downstairs and coordinate a problem with security.
Now, let us move on to our next tentative for today. The presentation of awards for Bicultural and Bilingual Study Program, also known as BSP.
BSP has been around in Bina Bangsa ever since 2019. The program is specially designed to equip the BSP student ambassadors with complexities and ambiguities of both the Eastern and Western world.
Through BSP, the student ambassadors were able to nurture a bicultural orientation amongst many groups of people.
BSP student ambassadors were also able to create a cultural mosaic in which they are able to hold dialogue with conviction in both the English and Chinese language. We would now like to invite Ms. Jacqueline up on stage to lead the awarding of certificates.
A very good morning, Mr. Hendro Wijaya, the superintendent, Ms. Martha Hapsari, the academic administrator, Mr. Richard, the principal, teachers, parents, and graduates. How are you doing? Good, yay. I hope everyone is in the pinkest of health. All right, so here we are for round two of BSP graduation. The scholars completed mountains of tasks to be able to stand in front of us today. They joined caroling sessions to usher in the Christmas spirit, joined a number of oratorical competitions, learned how to write in Chinese calligraphy and cursive writing, experienced the Chinese and Western cultures through preparing and cooking mouth-watering dishes, organized a community service to help an old folks' home and an orphanage and a whole lot more. I must say that I am immensely proud of the scholars they have become today. A big round of applause for them, please. So this year, BBS KJS proudly presents 13 BSP scholars. They will receive their honorary certificates based on their levels of involvement, criteria completion, and holistic growth. I would like to welcome Mr. Hendro onto the stage to give the awards away to the graduating scholars. The BSP scholars of year 22-23 are Cherry Aurelia, Gold Award. Juvincia Riadi, Gold Award. Clara Evangeline Chahyadi, Gold Award. Felicia Juliana Chen, Gold Award. Chloe Jennifer Lukman, Gold Award. Victoria Vivian Chan, Gold Award. Vincent Ongoputra, Gold Award. Nicole Calista Haryono, Gold Award. Joe Nathaniel Shukor, Gold Award. Jocelyn Patricia Kwa, Gold Award. John Alexander Santosa, Gold Award. Georges Dave Basri, Gold Award. And last but not least, Daryl Bradley Daniel Admaja, Bronze Award. Okay, we will quickly take a group photo. That side, sir. Two steps. Congratulations to the BSP scholars. We wish you all the best in your future undertakings. Thank you, Mr. Hendro. See you again next year.
Thank you, Ms. Jacqueline and Mr. Hendro, and congratulations to all the awardees.
Now, we have come to the main event of the day. Let us invite Mr. Hendro and Mr. Richard to present the certificates.
And Ms. Kirsty, the forum teacher of Secondary 4 Pascal, to call her graduates.
Secondary 4 Certificate Presentation Ceremony will now commence. Graduates of Secondary 4 Pascal, Charles Cahyadi Mulyanto. Ready. Thank you. Ave Maria. Last but not least, Winston Alexander Hendarto.
On behalf of Mr. Rohel, the form teacher of Secondary 4 Newton, to call up his graduates.
Good morning, everyone. Graduates from Secondary 4 Newton. Anderson Chung. Angelica Kinza Somar. Bianca Nicole Budi Surya. Clarissa Kathleen Wijaya. Daniel Brandy. Daniela Fiorenzia E. Gabriel. Fernandez Haliesius. Jocelyn Halim. Keisha Aquila Windy. Liam Nanda Setiawan. Lim Jian Hee. Naomi Hartato.
Nasya Eugenia Shannon Lim. Nathanael Sasmita. Philip Ali. Vanessa Joanna Cristabel Bong. Thank you, Mr. Hendro, and thank you, Mr. Richard.
Thank you, Mr. Rija. Thank you, Mr. Rija, Mr. Richard, and Mr. Hendro. The following graduates have been awarded the Secondary Education Certificate of Completion. But now, let us invite the form teacher of Secondary 4 Pascal, Ms. Kirsty, back on stage to announce the valedictorian of Secondary 4.
Thank you, Nathan and Eileen. A very good morning to everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, as is the custom in every commencement ceremony, an outstanding Secondary 4 student is chosen to give a speech on behalf of his or her schoolmates. A valedictorian is awarded to a student not just because of his or her academic achievement, but also because the contribution he or she has to the school activities, having positive impact to class environment, the ability to lead an event or team, and actively competing in various competition in and outside of school. I am truly blessed to be able to stand here to say a few words in regards to this wonderful student. Given her accomplishments to date, she still continually focuses to strive for improvement. She is a student who is outstanding and well-rounded, one who embodies not just a good breadth of knowledge, but also personal character. This student can be best described as smart, humble, mature, diligent, confident, and one who is willing to lend a helping hand when needed. A real sweetheart. A good academic standing leads you to your desired door, but a good character helps you create the door. Apart from that, she had made sure that she contributes in various activities that the school has organized by giving and striving for the betterment of each program as a whole. Demonstrating her continued involvement in the community, she has served as captain of Science CCA and was an active class committee, just to name a few. Well, of course, we teachers noticed, even though she was working behind the scenes, planning and arranging activities to performing on the stage too, she has been the go-to person. For outside school activities, she received the Distinction Award for ICAS Mathematics. She also earned other awards in ICAS Science, ICAS English Assessment, Global Writing Competition Singapore, the 5th Overseas Chinese Youth Composition Contest, and the 23rd World Chinese Student Competition, again, just to name a few. With my utmost pleasure and honor, let me welcome and present to you Bina Bangsa School Secondary 4 Class of 2023 Valedictorian, Miss Joanna Hermawan. Can we give her a round of applause?
Wow, it is such an honor for me to be standing here. I would have never expected this. A very good morning to everyone. Before I begin, I would like to take this opportunity to show my gratitude towards my friends, my teachers, and most importantly, my parents. They are the pillars for my success as they help me through my learning journey. First and foremost, my friends. Yes, you guys, don't be surprised. I've learned to work in teams. I've learned the importance of having friends, the importance of helping one another, and most importantly, being my cheerleader, especially when the tough gets going. I think all of you would agree when I talk about this particular group of people, our teachers. It is true that teachers are the beacon of light in a student's life. They have taught us from right to wrong, guiding us not only in academics, but also equipping us with knowledge needed when we face the next chapter of our lives. I would like to thank all the parents, especially my mom and dad, for their burning efforts in providing me with everything I need to grow and to be the best version of myself. I will not be standing here if it's not them. So why don't we give them all, not just my parents, but our parents, a round of applause. When I first started my academic journey in Bina Bangsa 2 years back, it was in the midst of a global pandemic where our normal activities and interactions had been thrown into disarray and face-to-face lessons were prohibited. I had to adjust to a new school environment in which I knew close to nobody, and every single interaction I had with anyone new was through a barrier of a screen. On top of that, I had to resist the distractions that were present while learning in my bedroom, where the place I studied was only a meter away from my bed. I'm sure I wasn't the only one who had to experience this. There are all sorts of things that can take away our focus from our lessons and assignments. It could be our phones or even the device we use to do online classes. All of this was such an out-of-the-ordinary experience for me as someone who has transferred schools in the past. Making friends when you've never really met any of your classmates in person was an inconvenience, as I couldn't really familiarize myself with them at first. However, this worldwide outbreak didn't only affect schools and their learning activities. It turned everyone's lives upside down. For me, even though I was confined to my home with all the various distractions, you can name it, from the games, to the phones, to the loud noises happening around you, it can be a bad environment for one student to study. But it did not stop me from finding different ways to adapt and change my learning pattern. The teachers are so very willing to accommodate to any time of the day with questions that I had and changing their lessons to accommodate our every need. But you know what? We managed to get through this. Now, we are all here attending this graduation in person and not through a screen. I believe it tells us something, a lesson that we can take from all of this. None of us knows what the future holds, similar to this pandemic, which nobody expected, but completely changed our lives. I think this teaches us to not take any moment for that we have for granted, and to not be afraid to take every single opportunity given to us, as everything can change in a blink of an eye. It just shows us that we should push ourselves to our limit so we don't regret it in the future. Today, we are closing another chapter and opening a new one. How fast time flies. You know, for me to be able to reach this point in my life, standing in front of you, it wasn't a walk in the park. I have made many mistakes and had to overcome various challenges in order to finally become who I am today. Life is similar in a way. We still have many years to go through where there will be hurdles and failures which are inevitable. Nevertheless, everything is a process where we have to get through each and every obstacle step by step in order to succeed. This secondary 4 year has flown by so fast, and soon we'll be having new uniforms, new books, and even new classmates. Sadly, some may be leaving us, but of course, there are some who will be continuing to JC1, including me. Nonetheless, I would like to wish everyone the best of luck in continuing your journey to achieve whatever you want in your life. In only these 2 years here in Bina Bangsa, I've made friends and precious memories that I would cherish for a long time. Once again, before I end, you all have contributed to my achievements, and I am truly grateful to be a part of your lives, as I know I'm glad to be in yours. Remember, as what the quote from Michael Phelps said, there will be obstacles, there will be doubters, there will be mistakes, but with hard work, there are no limits. Thank you.
Thank you, Joanna. Thank you, Joanna. May I call upon Madam Pan to present a token of appreciation to Joanna Hermawan.
we invite Mr. Hendro and Mr. Richard back on stage to present the certificates for Junior College 2.
We would also like to invite Ms. Marikar, the forum teacher of Junior College 2 Mendel, to call out the names of her graduates.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Merikar. Mr. Hendro and Mr. Richard, please remain on stage.
We would now like to invite Ms. Sylvia, the forum teacher of Junior College 2 Forbes, to call her graduates.
Thank you, Eileen and Nathan. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Now, I would like to call upon the graduates of Junior College 2 Forbes. Adriel Darren Mamahit. Thank you. Junior College Education Certificate of Completion. Ladies and gentlemen, as is the custom in every commencement ceremony, an outstanding Junior College 2 student is chosen to give a speech on behalf of his or her schoolmates. This young gentleman, whom I have known for more than 2 years, has not only performed extraordinarily well in all academic subjects and non-academics, but is also an exemplary student with praiseworthy character. Under our guidance, he has attained his impressive milestone in his life with great honor and integrity. He is an A-star student, yet very humble. Although he's an introvert, he's very observant. He received the Outstanding Cambridge Learners Award for the top in Indonesia Cambridge AS level accounting examination. He won the Bina Bangsa School 2023 Spelling Bee competition and was also part of the Bina Bangsa School Junior College Orchestra. As his form teacher and accounting teacher, I have witnessed he always takes his responsibilities seriously and complete his task with excellence. He's highly intelligent, motivated, respectful, trustworthy, courageous, and consistent. He's a role model to his peers and has shown us that he has been raised well at home. Therefore, he has left behind a very good legacy for the juniors and the incoming students to show to behind a very good to follow. Sorry, he is indeed a well-deserved recipient of a valedictorian title. Today, I'm honored to say we are proud of your many achievements over the years, your various accomplishments in almost all curricular and extracurricular activities, your brilliant achievements in academic and academic discourse are indeed acknowledged. Your sweet memories will forever remain in our hearts. My fellow colleagues and I wish to thank you for the uncommon zeal you have demonstrated towards your studies in your relationship with the teachers, management, your peers, and even among yourself. Ladies and gentlemen, Calvin Lai will now deliver his speech.
Thank you, Ms. Sylvia. Good morning to the management of Bina Bangsa Secondary School, guests of honor, heads of departments, teachers, parents, graduates of 2023, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure to be here today as part of this special occasion. I am extremely honored to be here as this year's valedictorian. I'd like to offer my congratulations to everyone in the graduating class of 2023. Today is the day that we have been waiting for the past few years. Today is the day that we celebrate the passing of a milestone, one that has taken us years to forge, endure, and appreciate immensely, one that I believe we'll never forget. First and foremost, on behalf of every graduate here, I would like to express our immense gratitude to everyone who has supported us throughout our journey. Thank you to our parents, who have supported us both emotionally and financially, for putting us in an excellent school like Bina Bangsa. It's truly an understatement, because we seriously can't thank you enough for everything you've done for us. Thank you to our teachers, who have guided us throughout our academic careers, who we've shared great memories with in and out of the classroom. We sincerely thank you for doing your best to ensure we do well in our exams and beyond. Thank you to the school administration, cleaners, and security, who have worked tirelessly in the background to keep the school a safe and clean environment. Thank you to our friends, who've shown us support, respect, and loyalty, even in tough times. Dear graduates, this is probably the last time we'll all be in the same room together. Look at the person seated next to you. They've been through a lot to get here, and so did you. What did we sacrifice to get to this moment? Did we sacrifice time with our family and friends? Did we end up not taking up a new hobby we've always wanted to try? Were these sacrifices worth it? I believe they were, since we made it to the finish line, resilient and hungry as ever. I know some of us found it difficult to balance our academic and personal life. Besides our academic struggles, like the A levels we just finished, or university applications, some of you might have been through personal problems like isolation, or friend group drama, or even heartbreak. However, throughout our time here, I believe we also learned to adapt in a new environment and still succeed. At the start of JC1, I was virtually a new student in my class, and I didn't really know anyone. However, as the months passed, I got to know some really interesting people. And I really appreciate my class for being supportive of me and for each other. We, the students of Bina Bangsa School, have gone through a lot, yet we somehow passed through the ring of fire against the backdrop of a pandemic. As you look back at all the memories you've made with your friends, all those revision papers you've done, all the struggles you face, whether it be academic or not, you should be proud of what you've accomplished. I work hard to get where I am today. However, I know that some of you have worked a lot harder than me, and I want to acknowledge your diligence and resilience. While you might not have achieved what you wanted to accomplish, you should be proud of what you did achieve along the way. Today we close one of the major chapters of our lives as we begin to look into the future. The future is full of uncertainty, but it's also full of opportunities. Thanks to the exceptional education offered by BBS, I have no doubt that we can continue our academic careers in many great universities worldwide. I know a lot of us are anxious, thinking about what happens next. We have the feeling of what now, after high school and then again after university. However, after everything we've gone through, I believe we can take on any challenge we encounter after the day. Fellow graduates, our graduation day is not the end, but rather the beginning of the next step of our lives. Let's remember not only the lessons learned from class, but also life lessons the school has taught us along the way. Remember the lifelong memories and friendships we made in the past few years, like our time during online class or our field trips. I distinctly remember chatting a lot with my friends during online class, and I remember about the fun conversation we had about anything that crossed our minds. Take a moment to appreciate all the parents, teachers, and friends who have supported us. The future awaits us, and with that, I urge you all to maintain the effort you put during high school, find your passions, and define your own success. When you leave PBS today, celebrate what you have accomplished all these years, and keep your head straight for your future. I wish you all the best for your future endeavors. Congratulations, everyone.
Thank you, Ms. Sylvia and Calvin. May I call upon Ms. Avin to present a token of appreciation to Calvin Lai.
Before we move on, we would like to ask the owner of the car-plated B1092HFP to briefly head downstairs and coordinate with security.
Now, may we invite Miss Wendy and the Chinese choir for a performance. Let us give them a warm welcome.
We'll be right back.
Thank you, Miss Wendy and the Chinese School Choir.
Music, sir. Parents, your children are thankful for what you have done for them. Our graduates' success today would not have been possible without the support of your love, prayers, and guidance throughout the years.
As a sign of gratitude, our graduates have prepared something special for you. Graduates, you may now proceed to give your parents the flowers.
my eyes, you were on my mind. Every time I close my eyes,
graduates, kindly gather back at your seats and remain standing. I mean, we sent Liam up already. Right? Please stand up, graduate. Please stand up.
Hey, wait.
May we request all graduates please stand up.
Now. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the 80 graduates of 2022-2023.
Graduating class teachers, kindly remain in the hall.
A child's momentous journey, and have a wonderful day.
request that the graduates move to the stage before leaving for a photo-taking session with their form and subject teachers as we call out your respective classes. Starting with Secondary 4 Pascal.
Thank you.
Junior College to Mendel.